Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Meta Platforms, which was slapped with a lawsuit by dozens of U.S. states accusing it of fueling a youth mental health crisis. Shares of Meta, which is also due to its release or to release its earnings report on Wednesday, fell nearly 1% in pre-market trading. And speaking of earnings, also in focus, shares of Deutsche Bank. The German banking giant reported a 3% revenue growth in the third quarter. Its stock surged over 6% on that news. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Carnival Corporation after an Australian court found that it misled its customers on its cruises' COVID risks in 2020. Shares of Carnival are down 0.7% before the bell. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly higher after China signaled more support to shore up its economy. The Hang Seng got a further boost from Hong Kong Chief Executive John Lee, who announced a cut in stamp duties for property buyers and lower levies on stock trades to revive its struggling economy. Australia's ASX 200 meanwhile closed flat after hotter than expected inflation lifted rate expectations. Some notable stock movements in the region: shares of Kokusai Electric popped as much as 30% in Japan's largest initial public offering in 5 years. The stock closed at 2,350 yen, valuing the chip equipment maker at $3.6 billion. Meanwhile, Country Garden shares slumped 2.8% in Hong Kong on reports a troubled developer defaulted on its dollar bond. Worries arising, the non-payment could trigger cross defaults in its other bonds, setting the stage for one of China's biggest corporate debt restructurings. As for Philippine shares, they managed to rebound after a five-day slide, but market activity remains low.
We are currently in a low-interest environment, as can be seen in the low market turnover, right, ranging from 2 to 3 billion the past few days. So this, coupled with the continuous rise in the U.S. 10-year bond yield, have likely caused the recent sell-off in the market. However, the market is only trading at 11.5 times PE, which is a significant discount to its historical average of 17 times PE. So we advise investors not to be too bearish on the market and instead take this opportunity and take advantage of this recent sell-off to pick up larger cap blue chip names as they bounce off their support levels.
Now, a China-backed railway project in Mindanao falls through due to alleged geopolitical tensions. Transport Chief Jaime Bautista confirmed the country has dropped Beijing as a funding source for the 100-kilometer railway project. He also noted China's interest in funding projects in the Philippines seems to have waned. Meanwhile, according to a senior economic manager, a Chinese official cited geopolitical factors in the lack of progress in Manila's infrastructure projects with Beijing. Bautista, though, assured the public the railway project will push through with other sources of funding.
We're looking at possible investors. We can also look at ODA support, no? And government. No? So it's a combination of Philippine government support, ODA, and private sector support.